Gents, it's so lovely to see you all here. Usually when I'm here on Monday mornings, I'm talking about Beethoven or Brahms or Schumann or Nielsen or these people. What marvellous music they are. And you can't say that about your own music, of course, can you? Of course it is. But most importantly, words of thanks in no particular order, as they say on these reality TV programmes, no particular order. A big word of thanks to all who've made this work possible, through all who've helped so generously with the commission. And I hope I haven't left anyone out. Catherine Arnold, Ted Greenfield, Michael McWilliam, Nicholas Kay, Kate and Nicholas Vinyl, Mary and Douglas Gibbs, Tony and Vraney Gould, all my great friends at the Blackheath Music Appreciation course. Thank particularly Lionel Lewis for all his work there, the Ralph Vaughan Williams Trust also. And also those who helped to sort of enable the instigation of the commission. Liz, who's somewhere there in the middle of the audience. Many thanks, Liz, it's so lovely to see you. Bill, who was playing those fantastic oboe solos there. Bravo, Bill. Sarah, who managed to get me to Trinity to speak to the flautist. I think there are a few of them here. Adam, where's Adam? Adam, there he is behind Tom. Now, he's an absolute star. The amount of work that that man does is absolutely incredible. But obviously, big, big word of thanks to Daniel for absolutely fantastic flute playing.
An honour it has been to have this piece written, and it's been just such a pleasure. Also, the fact that you may not know, but it's Matthew's 50th birthday today.
No, it's 21st!
He mentions in the programme note that he first decided to write this piece 30 years ago, and I'm quite glad I didn't know about it then, because I would have been nagging him every year since. So he sprung it on me last year.
And also a massive word of thanks to Tom, who has how many premieres of mine have you conducted, Tom? There's the Third Symphony, the Wind Serenade, as well as premiering performing many other works, and he's still speaking to me. It's amazing. So Tom and Tomato. And just finally, I'm going to shut up and have a beer, and you might think, thank God for that, you know. Music is such an important... Music is such an important part of all our lives, and out of all the things that people have said about music, there are two that always resonate with me, and they're from two of my very favourite composers. Carl Nielsen said, music is the sound of life, which I still think is one of the most telling things about this wonderful art form. And my dear old friend Malcolm Arnold also said, music, it's a communication. It's the best communication that there is. And I think when one's hearing performances of this sort of stature, it comes alive again. And also, perhaps ending with the words of Dryden in one of my very favorite poems. And if you can't recite Dryden on your 50th birthday, I don't know what you can. Alexander's Feast of the Power of Music. Just the last bit. He says, thus long ago, ere heaving bellows learned to blow, while organs yet were mute, Timotheus to his breathing flute and sounding lyre could swell the soul to rage or kindle soft desire. At last, divine Cecilia came, inventress of the vocal frame, the sweet enthusiast from her sacred store, enlarged the former narrow bounds and added length to solemn sounds. With nature's mother wit and arts unknown before, let old Timotheus yield the prize, or both divide the crown. He raised a mortal to the skies, she drew an angel down. Yet again, this evening has proved to me that music making of this quality is the most vital and essential accompaniment to civilized human life that we know. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.